Everyone, welcome back to the channel. What do you think of the new set? It adds a little bit of sex to the channel. I don't know why I said that. Today we're going to be talking about my day routine, what I get up to in a day as a lucid dreamer, as a YouTuber, as an entrepreneur, as a businessman, as a CEO to a company, managing director, whatever you want to call it. This is what I do in a day. If you're new here, my name is Giz and I am a lucid dreaming coach and entrepreneur based here in the UK. And on this channel, we delve into subjects such as lucid dreaming, entrepreneurship and more to make your lives more enjoyable, fulfilling and relaxed. And with that out of the way, let's talk about my daily life. Although I introduce myself as a lucid dreaming coach and an entrepreneur and a CEO or whatever you want to call it, my life is pretty boring. And recently I came to the conclusion that I can't really just do what I want to do in a day. Like whatever I feel like doing that day, I will do that day. One day I will get to that point. But for now, the way I've been organized in the last 20 years, my life wasn't good. So at the beginning of the year, I started using an app called Notion, which allows me to create a system which streamlines my effectiveness, my life in a better way. The more streamlined and systematized I can get my day-to-day routines done, the more stuff I can get done during the day. And then I'm more productive, way more productive. I finally understand what Jocko Willink means when he says discipline equals freedom. So my days are split into weekdays and weekends, just like most people's are. The reason that I do that is because I have a girlfriend called The Woman, and she has a typical job with a social media marketing agency, and she works weekdays and then has the weekends off. So my routine is kind of enveloped around that as to have the effect of being able to spend more time with her during the weekends. I will be making specific videos about my morning and evening routines a bit more so I can delve into the details of that in a future episode. So if you want to stick around for that, click the subscribe button that you see down below. And with that out of the way, let's start with my weekdays. I wake up at 8:30 every day, every single day without fail. As someone who studies sleep and whose dissertation was based on sleep deprivation and its effects on sports performance, I give everybody that same piece of advice. Don't worry about what time you go to bed, just wake up at the same time every single morning. And for me, that's 8:30. I've gotten into a routine so much that I normally wake up before my alarm goes off now. The woman wakes up before me and she starts work at about 9, 9:30, and she has a call with her team until about 10 a.m. So during the 1.5 hours in the morning when I wake up to when she finishes her call, I usually sit up and type on my laptop, mainly because I'm lazy. The absolute first thing I do is I record my dreams down in my dream journal. And I know I'm using a laptop for that. And there's, for all of you lucid dreaming purists, there is a reason for that. And I'll do a video in the future. Just stay tuned. So I wake up and I put as many dreams as I can into my dream journal. And I put as much detail in there as I can. And it's usually about 9 or 9:30 when I finish writing down my dreams in my journal. Then I do what's known as a morning dump. Thanks to Ali Abdal for telling me about that. Essentially, a morning dump is getting anything in your brain out of your brain and putting it down on something. So if it's a random thought about something, you dump it down. If it's an idea for a project, you dump it down. If it's an idea for an invention, if it's something that you need to do during the day, if it's X, Y, Z, A, B, C, it doesn't matter what it is, get it out of your brain and put it on paper. I organize that morning dumping to actionable chunks so that I can get them done into my to-do list. And I usually finish everything at about 9:30. There's more to my morning than that. But as I said, I'll make another video on that in the future. At about 10 a.m., ironically, I wrote this script before I moved my desk upstairs, but the woman and I used to share an office space in our house. So about 10 a.m., I would go and meet her in that office, and then we would sit down and have, you know, work together. So I'm not in the background of her Zoom call. It's a bit weird. Then I work 10 till 5 p.m. every day, solid. And what I do depends on what day it is and what's on my to-do list from the day before or my morning dumps. But I primarily work on two different things at the moment. Number one is my personal brand. I write a lot of stuff. My personal brand is anything that I do online. So it could be YouTube videos, it could be Twitch streaming, it could be editing, video production, it could be whatever it is, scripts for things, merchandise and options, making courses. I'm making a course. Yes, it's happening. But things like that, to that nature. I used to type so much because of personal brand that my wrist started hurting. I had to change like my desk and my chair in order to stop the wrist from hurting. If I have nothing to do for the day, I usually write about 5 scripts for videos. So as I said, a lot of writing. But before I write scripts for my videos, there are a couple of random tasks that I have to do in order to, you know, actually get stuff done. But once it's done and dusted, it's out the way, I never have to think about it again. One of them is transferring data from my Google Drive into my Notion account, and others involve just little bits and pieces so I can stick them into Notion. I transfer about 12 items a day, and I've recently only just finished doing this actually. Other tasks that I do alongside this for my personal brand is editing videos for this channel. I did edit stuff from my Twitch, but I've stopped Twitch streaming for a little bit just so I can, you know, get back into the routine creating content actually. And then also marketing campaigns. There's quite a few... Oi, stop it. See, my cat decides to join. There's quite a few other personal brand projects that I work on at the moment. What's up, Slink? What's up? Hey? What's wrong? You just woke up. Little baby. And most of my time is spent working on that. The second thing that I'm involved with at the moment is a company called That Seagull Bob. We are a multifaceted company that ranges from media production, hosting live streams, software development, podcast creations for companies, and much, much more. My brother's the main man in charge, and I'm like his right-hand man. And I work on a couple of things, but mainly what I do is decision stuff and writing. Again, my poor wrist. I don't do any video editing for this company unless a big project has come in from a client. The main thing I do is I film, because I have most of the fancy filming equipment. I create spreadsheets and things and other small stuff like marketing campaign things. Basically, whatever my brother tells me to do, that's what I do. After 5 p.m., so after that bell rings and, you know, I normally get up from the desk and I start cooking. I cook meals. I'm the main cook in the house, so I sort out food for the woman and I. And I actually really enjoy cooking. I never used to like it. It was like a thing that was in the way of me eating, and I didn't like that. But as I've gotten older, I've kind of enjoyed cooking a little bit more. I don't know if that's a normal thing or if that's something that's just happened to me, but yeah, I really, really enjoy cooking. So once I cook, we sit down, we relax, we watch TV. Even though we used to sit like 6 feet apart, we'd never talk to each other because we're both working. So we talk, the woman and I will watch maybe WandaVision or something like that. Then the woman may read a book or do some of her own personal projects or go for a state-sanctioned walking exercise for the day. And then what I'll do is I'll go back onto the computer at night. I'll either edit or, you know, relax a bit more, or I'll do a couple more hours on the various different projects, either Seagull Bob or Giz Edwards or Lucid Dream and stuff or whatever it is. And occasionally I'll play a video game. I've started getting back into Final Fantasy VII Remake. That's been great time. Stardew Valley soaked up loads of my time. Something like that. It's nice, chilled, and relaxed. I will go, there's so much more that I do in the evening, but I'll talk about that in a future evening routine video as well. Let's talk about the weekends. The weekends is basically the same. The morning routine is essentially the same as the morning routine for the weekdays. But depending on what time the woman wakes up and depending on what she wants to do today and what I need to do, my priority is to spend time with her, but sometimes I just can't do that and she can't do that either. So I'll either work on my personal brand or I'll work on That Seagull Bob. In my head, weekends are pretty much written off because I like to save that time. So if I can do work on the weekends, it's a bonus, it's a plus. If I can squeeze in some more Stardew Valley, I will. That's essentially what I do in a day, every day. And it's important to note that if you want to run a successful company, it's only as successful as the stuff that you put into it. So depending on what your goals are for the company, it might just be like, for example, That Seagull Bob. We want to be big. We want to have a company that allows us to live the lifestyle that we want to have. For my personal brand, I just basically use it as a bucket. It's a company that I use to bucket all of my content in. Depending on what you put in, that's how much you put out. So you don't have to be stressed working 90 hours a week doing company management, because realistically you don't need that. As long as you can pay yourself how much you want to pay yourself, or pay the other people in your company how much you want to pay them, then that's it. As I said many times in this video, I will do a more in-depth video about my morning and evening routines in the future weeks to come. So if you want to stick around for that, subscribe. And if not, I will see you all on Friday. Bye.